So in this video, I'm going to talk about charging cables for your electric vehicle and help you decide which is the correct charging cable you need to buy for your electric car. So your electric vehicle should come with a charge cable. Sometimes they don't. Sometimes vehicles are sold without cables because the previous owner has kept them. Sometimes people sell them on eBay to make a bit more money. It might be that you've damaged your cable. Some people drive over the connectors accidentally and break them. Or it could be you need to buy a longer cable. So I'll explain all the options. It is a little bit confusing when you're new to it, but bear with me, and hopefully this video will explain everything you need to know, and therefore you can buy the correct cable for your vehicle. So first off, let's just get one thing out of the way. You only need a charging cable when you're AC charging, so typically that's at home. When you're public rapid charging, you do not need a cable, because that cable is always on the rapid charger because it's very thick because of the power it delivers. So whether your car has got a CCS connector like this or a CHAdeMO connector like this, when you're DC rapid charging, you do not need a cable. So you only need a cable when you're charging your electric vehicle on AC power, and the majority of EVs will have a connector that looks like this. So it's a round circle with a flat top, and that is called a type 2. And on most modern vehicles, the type 2 port there is integrated with the DC rapid charging port, but it's still a standard type 2, but the whole combined port is called a CCS. So the combined charging standard integrates the DC rapid charging with the slow AC charging. But many older electric vehicles, and a lot of Asian electric vehicles like the Nissans and the Kia Soul, for example, uses a type 1 connector for AC charging. And that's a much smaller round socket with a key there at the bottom. So when buying a charge cable, you've just got to buy the right end for your vehicle. And that's quite simply a type 1 for the older electric vehicles or many of the Nissans, or a type 2 for the more modern EV. And then at the other end of the charge cable, they're all the same, whether it's a type 1 or type 2, they all have this at the charging end. And this is actually called a type 2 as well. So whether you're buying a type 1 or a type 2 charging cable, the charger end will always be that, because all chargers, whether that's home, workplace or public AC charging post, all have a type 2 charging socket. So obviously that does look a bit different to the type 2 you have on the other end. That's the end that plugs into the vehicle, and that's the end that plugs into your charger. And all charging units, if they have a socket, have a type 2 socket on them. So whether you've got an older EV with a type 1 or a newer EV with a type 2, the charging end is always type 2, which plugs into your charger. So while I'm talking about chargers, let's just quickly mention tethered chargers, because sometimes chargers don't have the type 2 socket on. Instead, they've got a cable with the connector straight on the end. So you don't use the cable that comes in the vehicle. This is called a tethered cable charger because the cable and the plug is attached to the charger. These are a lot more convenient, but you've got to make sure it's got the right end to suit your vehicle, whether that's a type 2 in this case or a type 1 for the older vehicle. So if you've got a home charger with a tethered cable, you don't need that other charge cable that comes with the car. But it's a good idea to have one, because if you're driving around in a car without a charge cable, you can't use destination chargers or charging posts in car parks and all sorts of locations now. You'll be limited to rapid charging only, and charging at home with your wall charger. So now you know whether you need a type 1 or a type 2 charging cable for your car, but there are other options. You've got the amperage of the cable to consider and the length of the cable. So let's just cover the length, because that's really simple. You just need to measure how long a cable you need to go from the normal parking space of your car to your wall charger. And typically a 5 meter cable will do most people. There will be times where you want a longer cable and you can buy 7.5 meter or 10 meter. You can actually buy longer than 10 meters as well, but some vehicles struggle with anything longer than 10 meters. So I would recommend to keep it below 10 meters if you can. So next, now let's talk about the amperage and whether you need a one phase or a three phase cable. This is where it gets a bit complicated if you don't understand electrics. So let's first off talk about cars with a type 1 connector, because that's pretty easy. So your electric vehicle with a type 1 connector here will either have a 16 amp or 3 kilowatt charger, or a 30 or 32 amp 6 to 7 kilowatt onboard charger, and then you just need to buy the appropriate cable for the vehicle. So when it comes to type 1, I've got two charging cables here. This one is a 16 amp cable and it is thinner and more flexible. And this one is a 32 amp cable and it's slightly thicker. So you need to buy the appropriate one for your vehicle. So if you've got a 3 kilowatt charging car, you can use a 16 amp charging cable. But if you've got a 6 or 7 kilowatt charging car, you need the 32 amp cable to take advantage of that. However, 32 amp cables are pretty much standard now, so you don't pay any more for 32, so you might as well buy a 32 regardless of what you've got, because if you've got a 16 amp or 3 kilowatt car, you can still use the 32 amp cable with it. And then of course this is a little bit future proof, because you'll be able to use it on other vehicles. So when it comes to type 2 cables, you do have more options. Again, you've got 16 amp or 32 amp, but you've also got single phase and three phase. And this is where you need to look at the specs of the onboard charger on your vehicle. If your AC charging is 7.4 kilowatt or below, it is a single phase charger, so you only need a single phase cable. But if your charger is an 11 or 22 kilowatt, then that is utilizing three phase, so ideally you want a three phase cable. And a telltale sign is looking at the charge port. This is the power pins here. You've got earth, live and neutral, and you see at the bottom there's no pins in there, because this is a single phase charging car. You've got earth, live and neutral and no extra lives. But if this was an 11 kilowatt or 22 kilowatt charger, there would be extra live pins down there. But three-phase charging is pretty rare now in the UK. There aren't many locations where you're going to be charging at any more than 7.4 kilowatt. There's a few car parks and things where they do have three-phase charging, but the majority of EVs in the UK don't support three-phase anyway. If you've got a Tesla or BMW i3, there's a handful of them, they will charge at 11 kilowatt or greater. So yes, if you've got a three-phase cable and you're charging on a three-phase charger, you are going to charge at that greater speed. But I suppose if you've got three-phase, you might as well buy the three-phase cable for the odd times where you'll be able to take advantage of that higher charging speed. So the way to tell if a cable is a single phase or three phase, firstly you can look at the connectors, and if there's no contacts in those bottom pins, then it's a single phase. But you can't always be sure, because sometimes they'll use a three phase connector and not actually connect those up. The best way is to look at the actual cable, and there'll be writing on the side of the cable, and it says there 3G 2.5 square millimeters. So that is a three cores of 2.5, so your three cores is your live, neutral and earth, so that's a single phase. If it says five cores of 2.5, then that's a three phase cable. And because a three phase cable is five cores, it is much thicker and a bit more unwieldy and can be a bit difficult to coil back up neatly in the boot of your car. So because of that, I would only buy a three phase cable if you really need it, because they are more expensive, they're a bit unwieldy. And obviously only get one if your vehicle supports 11 kilowatt charging or greater, and you're actually going to use a three-phase charging post or wall charger. So finally, just back on the amperage of the cable, if you've got a Type 2, then in pretty much all cases you're going to want a 32 amp charging cable. There's a few cases like the early Renault Kangoo vans where they had a Type 2 but they only had a 3.6 kilowatt charger and therefore it's 16 amp. So on those vehicles you can use the thinner 16 amp cable, but you can also use a thicker 32 amp as well, it does no harm. But for pretty much anything that's newer than 6 or 7 years old now, you're going to need a 32 amp charging cable if you've got Type 2. So it's likely only decision, apart from the cable length, is whether you go for single phase or three phase. So while we're on the subject of cables, let's just talk about portable chargers. So a portable charger allows you to charge the vehicle on a 3-pin plug. So you plug into a main socket rather than plugging into a wall charger. So when it comes to buying a portable charger, there's a lot less choices and decisions to be made. It's quite simple. You simply buy a Type 2 if you've got a Type 2 vehicle, or a Type 1 if you've got a Type 1 charging vehicle. And then apart from that, it's just the length of the cable you want. So typically these come in 5 meter, 7.5 or 10 meter lengths. And I would always go with the 10 meter. You do pay a little bit more, but it's surprising how long you need these, because of course your main socket isn't always going to be right near the vehicle. Often you would need to go into a garage, up under a door or through a kitchen window to get to a suitable socket, and a 5 meter just often isn't long enough to reach the charge port on your vehicle. So just bite the bullet, go with 10 meter every time, and you'll find it will be a lot more practical. So as for amperage and single phase or three phase, it's not applicable to portable chargers because a portable charger is limited to 10 amp, because you can't draw more than 10 amp through a socket for many hours on a time, otherwise it all starts getting a bit hot and melty. So all portable chargers are single phase 10 amp anyway, so it's just a case of choosing the correct length you want and whether you want Type 2 or Type 1 for your chosen vehicle. So when it comes to buying a portable charger, you don't need to go back to the dealership or the manufacturer to buy a branded one for your vehicle. These are really overpriced. Most OEM ones are sort of £400 or £500 or so, whereas you could buy exactly the same thing on Amazon or another source for much less than half the price. There is a case though that you do get what you pay for, so if you go and buy a cheap Chinese one at say £100, it's not going to be as good as a £200 one. Some of them have thermal management in the plug and they measure the temperature of the plug and they will shut down if that live pin starts getting a bit hot, so that's worth it. But I also favour the ones where they have an adjustable amperage and you can knock down the current. So rather than charging at 10 amp, you can charge at 8 or 6 amp. Of course, your charging is going to take longer, but you've got much less chance of it overheating. I've done a video review of one of those chargers, which I'll put a link to at the top of the screen and in the video description below. So there are an advantage of lowering the amperage. Obviously, it's going to take longer, but it is then much safer. Particularly if you need to use an extension lead, you've got to be very careful with extension leads. They've got to be proper 13 amp extension leads with thick cable. But if you're going to use extension lead, then certainly it's worth knocking the current down to 8 amp just for safety. But you've just got to be aware these portable chargers should be a temporary solution, not your permanent solution, because you are dependent on drawing all that power through a 3-pin plug and they're not really designed for it. So if you've got an electric vehicle and you can charge from home, then you do need to get a proper wall charger installed, and this will allow you to charge your car much quicker and safer because you'll be charging at 7 kilowatt or 32 amp. Plus you can take advantage of cheap rate nighttime electricity and get a lot more charge in that cheap rate period, so your electric vehicle is absolutely peanuts to run. And actually, I've got a good example of that. Again, I'll put a link to the video at the top of the screen and in the video description below. So I think I've pretty much covered everything. This was very much an impromptu, unscripted video because I had a telephone call this morning from an old customer asking about what charge cable they needed to buy. So I thought I'd make this video, and I've dug a few cables out, and I'm sure this will help others. In the video description below, I'll also put a link to a few of the most common cables that most people will want if you want to buy one on Amazon. So yeah, I think that's about it. As always, if you found it useful, please do click the thumbs up button. It really does help. Do subscribe to the channel if you want to know more about electric vehicles, and I'll see you on the next video.